In this video, we will see how to highlight, copy and extract hyperlinks from a Word document or from a website. Precisely, we will see first how to highlight all the hyperlinks in Word and then how to remove the yellow colored highlights. Then we will see how to easily copy all the hyperlinks using a Chrome extension called Linkclump. And finally, we will also see a macro that we can use in Word to extract all the hyperlinks into a separate Word document. The last one is my favorite because recently I published my new ebook Frugal Blogging, which is by the way selling for free now on Amazon. Download it if you haven't already before the prices go up. You can get the links from the description below. So yeah, in the book I have mentioned 400 plus hyperlinks and resources, but there was no way I could get them sorted and listed all in one single Excel workbook or a Word document. If not for nothing, I can use that list as a backup or a reference for later use. So let's now see how to do that. Within the Word document, where you want to find the hyperlinks, hit on Ctrl F to bring the Find and Replace window. Click on More. Click the Format button drop down. Select Font. And under the Font tab, click the drop down for Underline Style. And select this single line. Click OK. You will see the format as Underline here under the Find What field. So now under Find In, select Main Document and in the Reading Highlight drop-down, select Highlight All. Let's close this window and you can see that all our hyperlinks are now highlighted. So that was about how to highlight all the hyperlinks in Word document. Now let's see how to remove those highlights. This is pretty straightforward and really simple. In the same Find and Replace window, select the Reading Highlight drop-down button and choose Clear Highlighting. Also remember to click the No Formatting button so you can bring the Find and Replace command back to normal. So that was about how to remove the highlights in Word document. Now let's see how to copy these hyperlinks using a Chrome extension. To do this, you have to install the Linkclump extension from the Google Web Store. Links are provided in the description below. Since Linkclump can work from within a browser only, we now have to open our Word document as a HTML file. So let's go ahead and save the Word document as a HTML file. After opening it, right click on the Linkclump Chrome extension and select Options. Under the Actions section, click on Add Action. What we will do now is to temporarily add an action within this extension and then delete it once our task is complete. Select the config you want to have, choose Copy to Clipboard under the Actions section and click Save. Important note here, since we'll be using a local file opened in a browser, we need to provide Linkclump access to this local file. To do this, go to Chrome extensions URL and check the box that says allow access to file URLs for the Linkclump extension. Now start selecting the hyperlinks. A count is shown at the bottom corner of the selecting rectangle, which tells us how many hyperlinks have been copied to clipboard. Once done, you can paste them to any destination you want. I will paste them to another Word document. After pasting, you might have observed that hyperlinks are simply pasted as a plain text, but not as a real clickable hyperlinks. There is a simple fix to this. But before that, let's also see the macro method and then come back to fixing these hyperlinks. Go to this website and get this macro. Within Word, hit Alt and F11 keys or click on File Options Customize ribbon and select the Developer checkbox to show the Developer tab group. This setting is for Office 2010 and it will be different based on which version of Office you use. Now go to the Developer tab, click on Visual Basic. Right click on the project, select Insert and Module. Paste the VB code that you copied earlier. Hit F5 or click on this green play icon to run the macro. You can see that the macro picks all the hyperlinks from my book and creates a new document and pastes all the hyperlinks onto that. This is beautiful. However, we aren't done yet. There are some empty pages and we don't know how many hyperlinks got copied and pasted here. And above all, as we saw earlier, none of them are clickable hyperlinks. Let's now fix that. Copy all the hyperlinks by selecting them all. Open a new spreadsheet and paste them there. You can see there are so many blanks in between. Let's remove them. Select the column, hit F5 on the keyboard, click on Special, select Blanks, and click OK. Click on Delete from here. You can now see that there are 424 hyperlinks. Again, we have a problem. There could be duplicate links in these. So let's find duplicates and remove so we just have unique ones. Select the column again, go to the Data tab and click on Remove Duplicates. Just hit OK. Now we have got 370 unique hyperlinks. This is looking good now. Finally, let's make them all clickable hyperlinks. On another column, type this formula equals hyperlink and select the cell. Drag this formula to all the other cells too. Copy this column and paste them back into the Word document from where we copied the links to replace them. Make sure to use link and source formatting or it will be pasted as a table by default. That's it. Hope you learned something out of this video. If yes, please smash the like and subscribe buttons if you haven't already, and remember to stay techie. I'll see you again in the next video, and as always, thanks for watching.